Hello and welcome. Today I would like to talk to you about how cities can make better use of water that is available to them. So we will mainly focus on basic principles of water reuse. As you know, there is an increased pressure on water resources and cities are significant water users, but are also vulnerable to the consequences of water shortage, such as rationing of water, land subsidence and contamination of groundwater and river water with salt. So there must be smart ways to use water and to combat these effects. Humans need only about 2 liters of water to drink and a little more for food preparation. The UN suggests an absolute minimum of 20 liters per person per day for drinking water, personal hygiene and cooking. But if we look at water consumption per capita around the globe, developed countries hugely exceed this water consumption. Why is this? To understand this, we need to look at the water consumption in more detail. This graph shows the water consumption of a European household. As you can see, more than 2/3 of the water is not actually used for drinking or food preparation. About 1/3 of the water is instead used as a transport medium in toilet flushing. Another 1/3 is used for showering and bathing, and another large share is used for clothes washing. But this graph does not include households that use water for watering their grass and plants in the garden, which can be a much larger share than indoor water use. Such as here in California, where household consumption can make up to 900 liters a day, with 50% related to irrigation and watering the gardens. So what can be done to try to reduce water consumption? One easy way to do this are hosepipe bans, or simply not to be allowed to water the garden. Another way is to use dual flush toilets. So instead of one large toilet bowl with one type of flush, you use different types of flushes, a small one of about 3 liters for urine and a larger one of about 6 liters for the poo. Or even you could look at vacuum toilets, an innovative way of flushing your toilet that you may know from the plane. They use less than 2 liters per flush. Another alternative is to use water-saving showerheads. These either pulse the water in short intensive pulses or inject air into the water to give the same sensation as for larger amounts of water. Of course, an even better way to use less water is to change your behavior. You can take shorter showers, turn the tap off when brushing your teeth, or do not do the dishes with a running tap. But reducing water consumption is not all. Water is an amazing thing. Water can be used over and over again. One option is to cascade the water according to its quality. So the idea here is to use only the water quality that is necessary. Therefore, one can distinguish between potable water and non-potable water, or second quality water. For this, it is helpful to understand different water sources and water uses in the household. Toilet flushing and clothes washing can, for instance, be done with water of non-potable quality, while the other types of water needs should be covered with drinking water quality. Sources of such non-potable water are, for instance, water from the sink or the washing machine, so-called grey water, but also rainwater is a good alternative. Here is a simple example of how water from a sink can be reused for toilet flushing. Here's an example of grey water irrigation, and here one where rainwater is harvested in Ho Chi Minh City. But often the simple cascading is not enough, then water needs to be treated. Sometimes grey water needs to be treated to be used. This can be done through simple sand filtration, as shown here. The black water, so the water that contains feces, can of course also be treated and reused for non-potable purposes, like here in Santa Monica and here in Ho Chi Minh City. But it is even possible to reuse your wastewater for drinking. In fact, most of you will have done so via what is called unplanned indirect potable reuse. Often wastewater is discharged into a river and then used as drinking water further downstream, the unplanned potable reuse. Then there's something called planned indirect potable reuse. Here, wastewater is treated, often using energy-intensive filtration technologies, Water is then discharged deliberately back to the natural environment from which it is taken to supply people with water. Finally, direct potable reuse is a process where wastewater is treated and directly supplied as drinking water to the customer. Planned indirect potable water reuse is practiced widely, such as in Singapore and Orange County, USA. In Orange County, the water is injected to the groundwater and then abstracted from it for drinking water. The added advantage of this process is also that it replenishes the groundwater, thereby counteracting the saline intrusion. Finally, direct potable reuse is rarely practiced. Here an example from Windhoek, Namibia. The reason that direct potable reuse is rarely practiced is not so much technical or health related, but it is to a large extent due to public perception about wastewater. Or would you drink your own pee and poo?